Welcome to this week's GCN Tech Clinic, where, as always, we answer the questions that you've submitted using the hashtag AskGCNTech. So I guess we'll dive straight in and get started on our first question. And this comes from Reuven FG, who asks, "Hey Ollie," well, it's me today, unfortunately. "In terms of track cycling, I quite often see black straps over the track rider's shoes. Why do they use these? And surely they can't stop if they crash or their cadence just gets too fast." Very good question, actually. And something that I've wondered in the past before, because you can see some of the sprint riders, particularly on the track, really strapping their feet in tightly to the pedals. And the reason behind this is because the sprint riders develop so much power, and they particularly pull up on the pedal as well, on the upstroke of the pedal revolution. And this just helps lock their foot into place, because they develop so much force that they can sometimes overcome the spring mechanism within the pedals, and their foot will just come flying out, and it can lead to quite a big crash on the track, especially at some of the speeds that they're riding at. So that tends to be why they do that. And I have also in the past seen crashes on the track where riders have been sliding along and they're still attached to their bike for that very reason of the straps are holding their feet in place. They've eventually come to a stop and you see them unstrapping their feet and, well, going to tend to their wounds, which is never great to see. But anyway, that's the reason behind it. Our next question comes from Alien Sweetheart, which, very interesting name, thanks for that. And they're asking, "Should the rollers on my chain move freely or should they be rather stiff? They've been using the wax-based squirt chain loop for the last few months, and I've only recently cleaned the chain with warm soapy water. And they did notice that as they degreased it, they had a new sound of the chain rollers rotating as they were cleaning the chain with their fingers. And wondered whether that was okay, because now they seem to spin really fast, whereas before they didn't really seem to." But the reason behind that is because the wax-based chain lubricant, as you say, is quite dry and hard to the touch, which means the rollers won't tend to feel particularly free when you're trying to move them with your fingers. But it does serve a really good purpose when there's a big force applied to the chain when you're pedaling, and that offers really low friction and protection against wear. Whilst it can seem counterproductive, because when you've got a completely clean chain with no oil or wax on it, you can feel the rollers and they rotate really freely. Whilst it's great when you just turn them with your fingers, as soon as you apply any force or load through the chain, the roller will actually apply a great bit of friction to the rest of the chain and will wear prematurely, and also increase the resistance and drag that's coming from the chain. And you don't want that, because it's only going to slow you down. So applying a little bit of oil or wax to your chain will reduce the friction and make your chain last a little bit longer too. So it's a bit of a bonus all round. Next in, we've got Krishna Akram, who asks, well, he says they've got themselves a new gravel bike last summer, but then kind of realised that they like riding on the road too. Although they know that they can ride their gravel bike on the road, they're thinking of getting a road wheel set, so that's tyres and wheels. And is there a resource where they can find what wheels will fit on their bike? And will they need to get new disc rotors for this wheel set, because they have got disc brakes on their gravel bike? Oh, good to hear that you've been enjoying cycling, gravel riding, as well as on the road too. And it's good to know that you're enjoying spending time on the road, because it's great fun, isn't it? That's what it's all about. And swapping out some wheels to have a dedicated set of wheels with road tires on will make your road ride seem a lot nicer and a lot faster. And in terms of the compatibility of that wheel set, you're going to just need to check on the manufacturer of your bike's website, because normally they will list the specifications of each frame set, and you're going to need to know the type of axle that it takes, the width of it, as well as the diameter of the axle itself. So it will tend to be, if you've got disc brakes, that will use a through axle system, and then you'll need to know the spacing and then the size of that axle too. And in terms of the disc brake rotors, if your bike's got disc brakes, as you say, you are going to need to buy an additional set of brake rotors, because they'll need those to go onto your new wheels. New wheels don't tend to come with disc rotors included on them, because they come in a variety of different shapes. Well, they're all round, so all different sizes. So you need to check what size brake rotors your bike has got. Most common sizes on a gravel bike are either 140mm or 160. So double check those axle widths and double check the rotors, and you should be sorted in no time at all. Next question in is from Timothy Tanil, and asks, "Hey Alex and Ollie, my cleat bolts are seized up, and the more power he applies to unscrew them, the Allen key seems to just drill the bolt and round it off, and he's ended up with a disfigured hex-shaped Allen key bolt, which has no longer got any grip and is really struggling to undo them. So he's got sort of two questions here. The first one, are there any tricks to unscrew the bolts at this point? And he says he's managed to unscrew one of the bolts, but the screw hole is now damaged and he can't seem to put a bolt back in its place. Do we have any suggestions on how we can fix this? A good question, and it is very annoying when the cleat bolts seize into place on the shoe. It can be very frustrating, and I've had that in the past on a couple of shoes before. And my best advice is that if the bolts have started to round off, you've got a couple of options. So you can try to get a Torx piece that might be able to fit into the rounded Allen key hole. Sometimes you can get a slightly bigger one, and then if you bang it into place, it will sort of stay in place, and you might be able to just get enough grip to undo those seized bolts. But if you're still struggling with that, you're going to have to go to a bit of a last resort and end up getting the drill out and drilling the heads off of those bolts, which is, well, far from the ideal thing of what you want to be doing, but that is a surefire way of getting those cleats off of your shoes. Once you've got those off, you are going to have to be careful as you're drilling it that you don't cause any damage to your shoes as well. And like you say, the retaining nut that's inside the shoe, which the bolts would normally screw into, can be damaged as well. And these are possible to be replaced. Some shoe manufacturers will supply some extra inserts when you buy the shoes new, which you can switch out quite easily. It's just a case of taking the insole out of your shoe, finding the type that it is, and then just taking it out and replacing it. So it's quite a simple process, but you just need to check what type of insert your shoe's got and if you can get any new ones to replace it. But once you can, it's just a case, put those in place, and when you put your new cleats on, make sure you apply some grease to those bolts, and then next time, you shouldn't have the same problem again. Next in, good question we've got from Junzi Creations asking, they always put their chain on the small chain ring and smallest cassettes whenever they park their bike or keep it away for a while. And they say that's so that their rear derailleur spring tension is preserved, making the spring tension last longer. Is their logic sound, or are they just wasting their time? That's a good one. I have heard that before, and I've got to say, it's not something that I've ever done in the past. And the logic behind it is that by shifting into the small chainring and putting the derailleur into the smallest sprocket, that you're removing all of the tension from the springs in the derailleurs and the mechs to make sure they're not left with tension on them over time, which the theory behind this is that it could weaken the springs and the tension that they can hold the chain under. Whilst I do understand this, I'm not too sure I'm convinced by this because I've not seen any evidence or testing or research behind this to show that the springs degrade over time. So I think if you believe in it and you've got the time and you remember to change the bike into that gear as you leave it, that's great. But if you don't, I wouldn't sweat over it. Just leave it be. I'm sure everything will be fine. And on to our final question of this week's Tech Clinic. It comes from Ruben DeRuta, who asks, when they get out of the saddle, especially when accelerating at low speeds, the rear wheel hits the brake pads on their bikes, says they've got direct mount brakes. They've got carbon wheels, which they claim should be very stiff, but perhaps they aren't. Should they adjust their technique somehow, or what do we think the cause is for this? It's quite a common problem, this, just having the rear wheel rub slightly on the brake, and it's particularly common for taller and heavier riders, a little bit like myself. You can quite often find, as you're riding out of the saddle, the little bit of flex in the back wheel and the frame can just cause the brake to very slightly rub. And the first thing to check is just that your rear wheel is secured properly into the bike. Just double check that quick release is nice and tight and that the wheel is sat straight in the dropouts of the bike. That'll be the first thing. Then you can check that the caliper is centered correctly. So you can look to see that the gap between the brake pad on each side of the wheel rim is equal. So you can adjust that because that could be the reason behind it. And if you've done those, you could also check that your back wheel isn't buckled. It could be that you've got a slight buckle in the back wheel and that's just tucking up against the brake pad as you get out of the saddle, for example. And if you've checked these things and they're okay, it could be that your rear wheel has just actually got quite low spoke tension. That's causing it to have a bit of excess flex it wouldn't normally have. So if that could be the case, it's worth heading down to your local bike shop and just asking them to check that out for you. And they might be able to offer some good advice. And if it is that, they'll be able to retension the wheel for you. I hope that gives you a few good points to work your way through that, because it's a very frustrating problem to have and it can be quite tricky to sort out. So fingers crossed that sorts that out for you. As I said, that rounds off another GCN Tech Link for this week. I hope they've been particularly helpful for the guys that have submitted their questions. And as always, please do keep the questions coming using the hashtag AskGCNTech, and I'll keep an eye out for some good ones and pick them out for next week. Thanks very much. See you later.